FakeItEasy is a faking framework or mocking framework for .NET. It is really, really easy to use. And the best feature which I like about FakeItEasy is that it automatically fakes object and provides non-null value. So for a normal object, it's just going to create the object and return. And for arrays, it will create a zero length array and return. So that helps in terms of not getting object reference error in a lot of cases. Now for showing this demo, what I have done is I have created a few classes. So first I have a record type called user, and then I have a user provider interface, which has get users, which returns an array of user. The get method takes a name and returns a user. And then there is a get name, which takes the user object and returns a string name. And this is an async method. Now, in terms of the class, the implementation is pretty straightforward. The get user returns default, get also returns default, and the get name just returns the same name back from a task. As simple as that. And the idea is this particular class is probably interacting with the database. Now, next, what we have is we have a reward calculator class, and it is a class which does not have any interface implemented. And it has a calculate method which takes the user and it does a null check on the user and then also checks if the username is available in the existing reward dictionary. If not, then it throws an error. Otherwise, it returns the reward back. So this is what this class is. And then finally, there is a user processor class. User processor class takes the user provider and reward calculator in the constructor. And then it uses to get all the users. And then after that, it loops through the users and just call the calculate. And then finally returns a true if everything is successful. If the user is null or the length of the users is zero, it just returns false with the message no user. Now, what we are going to do is we are going to now test this particular class, which is the user processor and specifically this process method. So for that, we have this test class called user processor test. And as I already showed, I added FakeItEasy version 7.3.1 for the faking purposes and standard NUnit NuGet packages for testing purposes. Now here, first, what we are going to do is we're going to create a fake object for the interface and the class. So for the interface, we can do a.fake. And the interface is I user provider. And here we can say I user provider is equal to a.fake user provider. Similarly, we can also create a fake for the class reward calculator. But for any class, we can create a fake, but that does not mean that we can fake the method. A method can be faked if and only if the method is a virtual method. Otherwise, the FakeItEasy framework is going to throw an exception, and I'm going to show it later. Here, I can say reward calculator is equal to a.fake reward calculator. And finally, I can just declare the user processor here. So I can see user processor is equal to null. And in the setup, I can say processor is equal to new user processor. And here I can pass the provider and the calculator in the constructor. Now let's say we want to test a particular scenario. So the first scenario that we are going to test is going to be a simple test to see if the processing is successful or not. So for that, what we are going to do is we are going to provide implementation for get user, basically providing a fake implementation for get users, because that's the method which is used. So we can say a dot call to, and then here we can say provider dot get users, and if that is called, I don't need this, then dot return, and here we can say new array new user, and for the username I'm going to pass the name as Bob, because that is one of the value in the dictionary for the reward calculator. Because if I don't pass that value, the reward calculator is going to throw an error. So I have to pass Bob. And the reason I cannot fake the reward calculator's method, because the method in the reward calculator class calculate, it is not a virtual method. And also the reward calculator do not implement any interface. So for that, I have to pass appropriate value here so that reward calculator can work fine. For the address, I can give test, and then I can give one here. So that is what is going to be the return. And next thing, I'm just going to try to fake the reward calculator and show you that it is going to throw an error. So I can do the same thing. I can do a call to, and I can say calculator dot calculate, and calculator takes an user object. And here, to say that the parameter can be anything, we can use a and then user and dot ignore. Or we can also use, instead of ignore, we can use underscore. Underscore and ignore is practically the same thing. The ignore can be also defined by underscore. So we can do that. And then after that, we can say dot, and here I can say 20. And now let me just run this so that I can show you the error. And then we will go with the next set. So if I run this method now, and you can see the test is failed. And the reason for that is the current proxy generator cannot intercept the method rewardCalculator.calculate for the following reason, and it says it is a non-virtual member. So as I said, this is something which is not going to work. So we can get rid of this. And then what we can do is we can say processor.process. And after that, the processor.process is going to return a tuple, a bool. So we can say result and response. And after that, what we can do is we can check this value, of course, using standard assert. So we can say assert dot is true, and we'll check for result. And similarly, we can check that the response is not null using assert.isNotNull. So this is what we can do. But apart from that, what we can do is we can use the fake it easy to see if method like get users and get user, all these are getting called or not. So for that, what we can do is we can say a dot call to, and here we can say provider dot get users. And after that, what we can do is we can say whether it has been called or not. And for that, we can use one of this method. We can say must have happened exactly once, or must have happened a number of times matching, or just must have happened, or must have happened once or less, once or more, twice, twice or less, twice or more. So for us, it's once exactly, so we can say it must have happened once exactly. And now if I run this test is going to be successful and it is going to be green. It is going to run all the text successfully. Similarly, we know that the getUser method should not have been called. So we can just do the same thing. We can just copy paste this and we can say, instead of this, we can say get. And the get method takes a string name and returns a user. So we can say a string dot underscore. And here we are going to say must not have happened because this should not be called. It is not part of our process. So now if we run it, we'll see similar response in which that it is going to be successful. Now let's create a second test. And that test we can say test 2. Most of the things is going to remain same. And let's just name it as test 2. Now I'm just going to run it to show a problem that we are going to face when we have multiple tests with the object defined at a class level. So if I run this test, now it's the same test twice, it should technically work. So let me just run. And you can see the second test passed. And the reason that it is going to show here is expected to find exactly once but twice for get users is because the object is defined at this level. So what we should do is we should get this 3 into individual method, and we'll also have to get rid of this from the setup. So we can get it out of here and we can just declare it here. Get rid of the null, it's not needed. Same for here, the null is not needed. Now the object is created internally, and if I go and run that same couple of tests now again, both the tests will be successful this time. You can see both of them are successful. So this is something to keep in mind. Now let's do one thing. Now let's see how this can react, or how we are going to react if it throws an exception. And in this case, this has nothing to do with PKTC itself, but this is a feature of NUnit which you might have used. So if we pass, instead of Bob here, if we pass something else, when the reward calculator will be calculated, reward calculator will not find the new name. So it is going to throw an error. So let's change Bob to something else and let's make it as test. And now what we have to do is, now this is not going to work, so we'll have to use assert.catch, and the exception is argument exception, so we can say argument exception, and then here we can use a lambda function, and then we can get rid of these two. And this should still be there. The getUser should have been called only once, and get should never be called. So now if I run both the tests will be successful as expected. The other interesting thing that we can do is calling this method in an ordered fashion, meaning we can call it orderly. For example, now if we go and change the implementation of the processor, after the getUsers method, if we call the getUser, then we can do some sort of ordering. So let's say here var user1 equal to user provider dot get, and then for the name I can just pass test. And then what I can do is here, Now, at this point in time, let me change this to Bob so that I do not get any error. And let me just call it var result response equal to process. And now what we can do is we can do this might have called exactly once, and then we can chain it. We can make sure that only after get users is called, the get is called. So to check that, we can use after the must have happened, we can use the keyword called then. And inside of then, we can do the exact same thing. But here, the must not have happened test case is not going to work with then because this returns a void. But our goal is to see that get call must have happened exactly once. So here we can change it to must have happened exactly once. And you can see the reds quickly is gone. Let me get this to the next line. And this time, if we test the test two, this test case is going to pass. So let's run this and we can see this working. But if we change the order of operation, so if we just flip this and put this one first, and then we put the then and call this one later, now this should fail because get does not get called before get users. And now if I go ahead and try to run the test two should fail this time because the get gets called after the get user. And you can see it failed. And it failed because get once exactly, you can see the call were found not in the correct order among the calls. So get users is getting called first and then get, whereas we are trying to check get before get users. So this is also a very handy feature which can be really useful checking the order of operation. Apart from that, there are a couple of other things I wanted to show, which I'm not going to go through the implementation, but just show quickly. One thing is just like we do return, we can also throw exception. So we can say throw and we can throw a specific exception. It might be useful in certain scenarios. The other thing we can do is we can also fake lambdas or functions. So we can say a.fake. And for the fake, we can actually fake something like func. So we can also fake delegates or lambdas. And similarly, we can also fake collections. So to fake collections and create fake collection, what we can do is we can do a.collections of fake. And here we can give the type. For example, we want to fake a collection of user. And then here we can provide the number. So we want to create 10 fake users as an array. And as you can see, this is going to return a list of ilist of user. So this is another handy feature if you are using an array as an input parameter and you just want to pass some fake values. This is extremely helpful. So that is all I wanted to cover for today's video. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if you are new to my channel and if you think you are getting value out of my channel, please subscribe to my channel. And thanks so much for watching this video.